The rift between CSOs and the government of Uganda seems to grow bigger every day as each of them accuses the other of undermining their mandate. Over the years, several CSO premises have been raided by security agencies, while others, like ActionAid, have had their bank accounts frozen on allegations that their activism is intended to promote political unrest. During a regional civic space conference in Kampala, government expressed mistrust of the activities of CSOs, and it was revealed that government is probing a number of them for allegedly sponsoring political violence and protests led by opposition groups.
Uganda right now, we are just trying to remind the civil society that please do your mandate. Do not involve yourself in issues that can cause mischief, which can cause insecurity around the country. And we try also to do it based on the information we get, and also based on the investigations that can easily come out to entirely link that particular organization to areas which could be causing insecurity, or even funding activities that can cause insecurity in the country.
The CSOs, on the other hand, denied the allegations, instead advising the authorities to resolve their issues with the populace instead of pointing fingers.
There is no way a civil society organization can fund protests. What I observed as a citizen is that these protests were spontaneous. In Uganda, mainly in Kamocha, where Bob Wine works from, in his constituency in Chebando, in Mitiana, in Mpiji, where he was born, and in Mitiana, where Zake comes from. These protests did not need anybody to fund them.
The attack on NGOs has not spared the media, as a number of journalists have been assaulted while in line of duty. Human rights defenders demand that this should end soon so as Ugandans can fully enjoy their civic rights.
A comprehensive, respectful and transparent discussion involving all the key actors, namely the media guys in the field, the editors, the managers, and the security guys, including some government officials.
I want to underscore the point that the arrests, torture, closure, and siege of civil society organizations working in areas of rule of law, governance, and human rights happens when the governance space closes or is closing.
The Regional Civic Space Conference is aimed at finding ways of advocating for civic rights and democracy in the East African region, as well as promoting cooperation among the member states without undermining their federal autonomy. Rachel Nachuala for Urban TV.
We are also awaiting, the minister has told us that an investigation is going on about some NGOs that are protesting, that are supporting.